स्टैंडर्ड 9th चैप्टर 7 पार्ट 2 एनर्जी फ्लो इन एन इकोसिस्टम। लेट अस रिकॉल वॉट वी स्टडीड इन अवर लास्ट सेशन। दिस इज फूड चेन। इन दिस फूड चेन वी कैन ईजीली सी हाउ ईच एनिमल इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन अदर एनिमल एंड दिस इज फूड वेव। हियर एवरी एनिमल इज फूड फॉर वन और मोर एनिमल। आफ्टर दैट वी स्टडीड अ पिरामिड, एनर्जी पिरामिड। इन दिस पिरामिड यू कैन ईजीली सी प्रोड्यूसर एट द बॉटम। इट इंक्लूड ऑल द प्लांट्स विच कैप्चर द एनर्जी फ्रॉम सन। दिस प्लांट्स आर बीन ईटन बाय हर्बीवोरस, द एनिमल्स विच आर फीडेड ऑन प्लांट्स। दिस हर्बीवोरस आर बीन ईटन बाय कार्निवोरस। कार्निवोरस आर दोज एनिमल्स विच आर ईटिंग हर्बीवोर एनिमल। कार्निवोर्स डिपेंडेंट ऑन हर्बीवोर एज देयर फूड, दे ईट दोज एनिमल्स विच आर हर्बीवोर्स। एंड देन सेकेंडरी कंज्यूमर, सेकेंडरी कार्निवोरस, दे आर ईटिंग दिस। एट द टॉप ऑफ दिस साइकिल यू कैन सी अपेक्स कंज्यूमर्स। दीज अपेक्स प्रीडेटर्स दे आर ईटिंग दीज लोअर एनिमल्स। Now we have already studied this energy pyramid. In it we observed that only 10% energy is passed to next trophic level. First we saw primary producers. Primary producers are those who get 100% energy from the sun. Primary consumer get only 10% of that and 90% is passed in the form of heat in environment. Then from primary consumer only 1% is passed in next tropic level, that is secondary consumer. Rest 9% is passed to the environment. From there to the tertiary only 0.1% is energy is passed, and from there to the apex predator only 0.01% energy is passed. Now let us see our next topic which we are going to deal today, biogeochemical cycle. This is the cycle in which bio means life, geo means earth or land, and chemical cycling is the procedure which we are going to observe now. The flow of nutrient in an ecosystem is cyclic. All organism need nutrients for their growth. These nutrients are continuously transferred from biotic to abiotic and from abiotic to biotic factor within an ecosystem. This cycle operates continuously through the medium of biosphere, which is formed by the lithosphere, atmosphere and hydrosphere. Students, do you know the energy flow through an ecosystem is one way? Let us see how. The sun is the most important source of energy in an ecosystem. Green plants store some of the solar energy in the form of food by the process of photosynthesis. Before reaching the decomposer, this storage of energy is passed on from one trophic level to another trophic level, from producer to herbivore, from herbivore to carnivore, and from carnivore to the mixed consumers. Decomposer releases some amount of energy in the form of heat. However, no part of energy ever return to the sun. जर सूर्याकडे आपण कुठलीच एनर्जी पुन्हा परत पाठवत नाही आहोत, दॅट्स वाय वी कॅन से that the eco the energy flowing through the ecosystem is only in one direction. This cyclic flow of nutrient within an ecosystem is called as biogeochemical cycle. This biogeochemical cycle is further subdivided into two parts, gaseous cycle and sedimentary cycle. Gaseous cycle. In this type of biogeochemical cycle, the major reservoir of abiotic gaseous nutrient material exists in the gases phase in Earth's atmosphere. At carbon dioxide, oxygen, nitrogen, water vapor, etc. are included in these gases. Second type is sedimentary cycle. An accumulation of main abiotic nutrient material is found in the soil, sediments and sedimentary rocks, etc. of the earth. It also includes soil components like iron, calcium, phosphorus, etc. Gaseous cycle is speedier than sedimentary cycle. For example, if carbon dioxide is accumulated in an area, it is quickly dispersed or absorbed by the plants. Climatic change and human activities seriously affect the speed, intensity, and equilibrium of this cycle. Hence, various aspects of this cycle are extensively studied nowadays. Carbon cycle. Let us define it first. The circulation and recycling of carbon from the atmosphere to the living organism and after their death back to the atmosphere is called as carbon cycle. Then what are the importance of this carbon cycle? Here are they. Through photosynthesis and respiration, abiotic carbon atoms are circulated and recycled into biotic form. Second, plant convert carbon dioxide into carbohydrate by photosynthesis and also produce and other carbon compounds like proteins and fats. Herbivores are dependent on plants for food and carnivores are dependent on herbivore for their food. In this manner, biotic carbon is continuously passed on from one living organism to another. Transported from plants to herbivores, from herbivore to carnivore, and from carnivore to the apex consumer. Finally, dead organisms are decomposed and carbon dioxide is released again into the atmosphere and is used again by a living organism. Carbon dioxide is also released into the atmosphere through a biotic process. The oxygen cycle. Let us define it first. Circulation and recycling of oxygen within the biosphere is called as oxygen cycle. Now let us see what are the importance of oxygen cycle. Oxygen is continuously produced and used up in the atmosphere. Oxygen cycle include both biotic as well as abiotic components. During photosynthesis, biotic process, plant use carbon dioxide and release oxygen in the atmosphere. Plant utilize this oxygen for respiration and release carbon dioxide. The release carbon dioxide is again used by plants
for photosynthesis. Oxygen is also utilized in various other processes such as combustion, decomposition, corrosion, rusting, etc. As oxygen is highly reactive, it reacts with other elements and compounds. Oxygen is found in various forms such as molecular oxygen, that is O2, H2O, water, CO2, carbon dioxide, inorganic compound, and etc.
Nitrogen cycle. Friends, do you know 78% of our total atmosphere is covered by this gas? It is nothing else but nitrogen. Nitrogen, which make up the majority portion of the air, is needed by the organism to survive. Yeah, without nitrogen, we can't survive. Have you ever imagined? Whenever we ask you a question that why, which gas is important for us to survive, your answer is always oxygen, right? But nitrogen is the another important gas for our survival. Let us see how.
Let's first define nitrogen cycle. The circulation and recycling of nitrogen gas into the form of different compound through various biotic and abiotic process occurs in the nature is called nitrogen cycle. This nitrogen cycle is very important. Let us see how. Nitrogen fixation, have you heard about it? In this step, nitrogen is converted into nitrate and nitrite through atmospheric, industrial, and biological processes. Ammonification. Here, ammonia is released through decomposition of dead animals and excreta waste of organism. Nitrification. In nitrification, ammonia is converted into nitrite and then nitrate. Denitrification. It involves conversion of nitrogen compound into gaseous nitrogen. So, here we end with this chapter. All the best for the study.